Scene one, whatever one, take four.
Dude, I had this weird dream that I'm sleeping in my bed. Most of the time in my dreams are waking dreams. I'll wake up, but not like really, but I'll just be in my bed and weird things will happen around my bed.
Right.
And like one time this like band comes in, like the front, and I probably like stood up in bed and was like going like this or some shit, but like no one was sleeping with me at the time, so they couldn't see.
Right.
But they walk in and all of a sudden I'm like conducting this marching band, they're playing at me.
My name is Grizz, and I'm a saxophone playing electronic funk music producer from Detroit, Michigan.
If you didn't know by now, my name is Grizz, yo, Detroit is cool for fucking people.
Everybody just...
Let me see you get down.
Right, so Rebel Era tour ends, and it's the greatest success of a tour that we've had, like just massive, positive, and awesome response from it. Right after a record ends, you kind of start thinking about like, what's the next step? You know, where do we go from here musically? You know, what's inspiring? What do you have to do? For this next record, it's like we can't use samples anymore. So we have to come at this and give them the familiarity and like the same vibe and that same feeling, but have it be 100% original, 100% like from the players themselves, from the source. So we had to find what that source was. Like we wanted this to sound dusty and old, but like beefed up in like the new electronic dance music digital realm, you know, to like be played in like high fidelity systems and like in like a high fidelity world. Getting off the tour and Josh Hanford, my good friend and photographer on this journey with me, you know, we're just getting into it, talking about like the new project. And I'm like, yeah, I'm like trying to record all these like funk artists and stuff. And he's like, you know, you've ever heard these guys, I'm sure you're familiar with Will Sessions out in Detroit. He's like, yo, well, we have to check him out. So we're driving around listening to Will Sessions. I'm like, man, this is like the jam. You know, these guys are the jump up. These guys are amazing. 2 weeks later, I'm still in Detroit and we're just hanging out. Josh and I roll out to Sam Bobian's basement and we just start creating stuff.
You want to like just take it back and reduce without losing the integrity of like the most amazing things that have happened.
Yeah.
Getting like A section, getting like B section, like rolling that shit out.
Yeah, totally, man.
And we're all sitting there and it's like, one, two, three, what do we play? You know? And I'm like, okay, you're right. A minor, 90 BPMs. The way that all the studio sessions ran was that we were doing it impromptu, off the cut. Going into the project, the intention was to record these musicians and get an idea of samples from them, like the rhythm part of the song, like the stuff that I would sample. Get the drummer to start playing something, get the bass player to start playing something. Now we kind of got a cool little groove going, and then you get the guitar player to kind of play something, and you kind of got this little like cool break thing going, and then just like, bam, all of a sudden we're recording this crazy stuff, and like I'm sitting there like, this is gold. You know, this is the coolest thing I've ever done in my life. Had like my first ever studio experience with live funk band. And this is a very powerful feeling to get into a room with a bunch of insanely talented musicians who are just like, man, like, let's just play some really cool stuff. It was really, really good to get with the Will Sessions guys in their basement and just like do this really, really raw funk kind of thing. And the stuff we recorded started to really feel like magic. You're actually interacting with sound, and that started to feel really cool.
That was dope. Just take it, take it, take it, take it, take it, take it. Cool. Sounds like you got a lot of that track.
We could do some horns or something that's like. Oh, can we do that on guitar? Like, just so I have the line.
At that point, we wrapped up the Will Sessions stuff for that week. And finally got a call from my management that was like, hey, we just got off the phone with the people at Daptone Records, and they're really, really interested in the project, and they want to help you facilitate like the dream of this sound, and they want to be the players. And I got on a plane to head out to New York.
This next jam is going to be the jam of the jam.
Getting somebody else to like riff on your shit, you know, like on your ideas, like creates more ideas, which
is exactly
so instant.
Yeah, it's reputation.
And the first day in Studio G in Brooklyn was like kid in the candy store kind of a thing. All these old compressors and limiters and distortion units and amplifiers and crazy, crazy old analog gear. Stuff straight from the 70s.
So we'll just go like that. Mm-hmm. And usually I'll start with drums, bass, guitar.
Okay.
And then keys, and then we'll start bringing it towards.
All right.
So let's keep the start just. Yeah. Yeah. Cool.
Members from Budo's band, members from Antibalas, and do these amazing Afrobeat guys, and just so easy to work with these guys. Like, they got it, you know? Like, this was their style of shit. They're like, man, I know exactly what you want me to play. Okay, word, yeah, more like this, you know? And you're like, exactly. I don't even have to say anything, I just need to give you that look, and all of a sudden you're like, yeah, more like this, right? And you're like, oh, yes, that's my shit.
Oh, you're back? Okay.
That was tight, that was tight.
So get him at the 16th. Hey man, let me start you from the top here, and 8 clicks in.
The New York sessions were great, and every single night I remember going back and like getting cuts from the sessions and like working on the music on my computer just like into the wee hours of the evening.
So this one.
We're getting there. We're getting towards that 60s and 70s like golden era of soul and of funk. And like we're really starting to tap into the magic.
Alright, my shit's getting tight. I think we got it.
I got blisters on my fingers.
So I talked to my boys, X-Mag, who are really good friends, and they're like absolutely fantastic musicians. And I was like, man, I've got this dream, this little vision, and I want to take you guys on a trip with me. So book them out, and my good friend Muzzy out there to record some guitar with me. I had Eric Bloom, the trumpet player from Lettuce, out there. We booked this cabin in the middle of Manistee National Forest on 12 acres of land. And we booked it out for 2 weeks, and we're just like completely out there. So we're driving and driving and driving 4 hours north into like the depths of the woods in Michigan, and just get like completely lost. Like turn our cell phones off, no cell service, just us in nature and music every single day. And for 2 weeks, we would go ahead and proceed to create like some of the most like insane stuff. Like the mantra of the trip was like to find the ultimate funk groove, to be like the funkiest thing ever.
Can you go your second octave?
I can do that, yeah.
Like do like a fill. Like just run on the scale.
Yeah, so 30, then we can do that whole thing.
Yes.
Every single night we have family dinners.
You think two more tomatoes? One tomato?
Two more tomatoes. Yeah. I'm gonna cut meat on this thing. Crank was the.
Crank!
It cranked the first boss. Oh, yeah. Turtles in Time.
No, that's. No,
on the bridge.
Oh! We're sitting around the campfire making s'mores, like drinking, sharing stories, like. It was like the ultimate musical dream. It was like the most inspiring, insane 2 weeks of my life. And I'm gonna have to do this every year now.
It's gotta be on beat 4. That's
really what this is.
I was just kind of working on it afterwards, and it just kind of got this one thing stuck in my head, this one idea. The idea was to like record a group of people singing this hook, you know, to create this like this really big moment, this really cool, like, thick moment. The idea turned into like, yo, we need to get a children's choir. We go out there and we get this children's choir in Los Angeles, and like, I'm like, man, this idea is finally coming into fruition.
Come in, we already have, you know, 3 takes, which sound really good as they are. Maybe have everyone change spots.
And today we're here in this really, really cool studio in Los Angeles to record another piece of this really, really cool, awesome album that you guys are going to be part of. And I'm so grateful that you guys get to be here with me today and do this. So thank you so much for coming. I appreciate it a lot.
Do you guys like funk music?
Yeah. Funk music is the most groovinest kind of music that ever existed ever. And it was like the most popular and awesome dance music in like the 60s and 70s. Like this was like the jam. This is what everyone was doing. And that's kind of what we're doing here today, is we're feeling the groove and we're enjoying and dancing. That's what funk music is. Funk music is a feeling.
The most intimidating thing that I've ever done in my life up until this point is standing in a room with a bunch of kids from the ages of 7 to 11 years old and having them stare at you with the brightest eyes and just being like, what do you want us to sing? You know? That was like the coolest moment, man. Just sitting there and like having these kids singing back the lyrics that you'd record at 2 o'clock in the morning in Boulder, Colorado, you know, miles and miles and miles away, and having them sing it back to you, like, it almost brought tears in my eyes, man. I'm like, this is amazing, you know? So the lyrics go, I wanna dance, wanna sing to the rhythm of the beat. I wanna dance, wanna sing
to the rhythm of the beat. Feeling all right, 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 feeling all right.
kids did such a great job. And we're all sitting there and these kids are sitting in front of me. And even worse, like all their parents are behind me in like the tracking room with like their phones out, like videotaping this mystery Grizz guy, like directing their kids with these vocals. Like that was really, really insane. But it ended up being so rad. And that song is one of the most special things I've done yet. I'm just so stoked for it. And the kids did such a great job. This song is one of the most inspired and cool things I've ever done in my career. I had this whole album of funk music, and I completely wiped out the compositions of what I was originally doing. I had this funk album in mind, and I just reorganized it. I took all of these things apart and dismantled them and brought them out and thought about it with a completely new headspace and started putting it back together and taking, you know, the guitar from Detroit Sessions day whatever, 3, and then putting the bass line of New York Sessions day 6, the vocals, chopping them up and putting them in weird places, and the drums, and making these new compositions completely. And it just started to become this like massive consumption of what I was doing. Like I was just putting out so much content that it was like, I couldn't stop, man, I was on fire. And that was the really inspiring moment when I like understood that I had 100% complete musical freedom for the whole project. And it took new life and new form and became really a Grizz album, the new Grizz album. If anything, I just urge you to check the music out live. That's always the biggest thing. That's where like the most fun happens. You get to really understand and feel the emotion of the music.
It's all good, baby.
The Grizz music lives in the live venue. I want you to come and see my show and live the music with me, because that's what's important to me. Thank you.